Are you often scared about losing your partner? Do you need constant reminders to tell you that they love you? Are you scared that your partner's going to find someone better than you? Then watch this video because this is for you. Hi my love bugs and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Ruby Dahl and I am a best-selling author of 5 books of poetry, prose and bite-sized self-help. I write about love, healing, self-love, heartbreak, moving on, grief, the likes, and my most recent book Between Us is available to order from the link below in the captions, so make sure that you grab your copy. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the bell icon below so that you are constantly updated about my new videos and everything else. So today I wanted to talk about something that is the driving force behind our relationships, the security in our relationships, and just generally the relationships that we form with other people, and that is attachment styles. As social beings, forming relationships with other people and maintaining those relationships is one of our core characteristics. It's something that not only contributes to the happiness in our lives, but impacts the quality of our lives moving forward. And most specifically in the COVID pandemic, we realized how important it is to maintain relationships and to rely on these relationships during difficult periods in our lives. Because connection and relationships are really, really important to our mental and emotional well-being. But just because we have this shared instinct to maintain relationships with other people, it doesn't mean that we should approach all relationships in the same way, or that we all do approach relationships in the same way. And this is where attachment styles comes in, because they help us understand how we connect to other people and how much our childhood experiences have impacted us in the formation and maintaining of relationships. From a really young age, we learn about relationships. We learn about relationships from our parents. We learn about our relationships from forming a relationship with our parents, through observing them, through the experiences we have. Our years between 3 to 7 are so vital in allowing us to form healthy attachment styles. The experiences that we have moving forward when we go to school also further contribute to this. So all of our early experiences have a huge, huge impact and determine to a great extent the kind of relationships that we're going to have moving forward. Simply put, if growing up you were nurtured and well cared for, where both of your parents were responsive to your emotional and mental needs, then a secure bond was formed. Alternatively, if as a child your needs weren't met and you weren't able to have a stable and secure relationship with your parents, then this is going to have a negative impact on your relationship and attachment styles going forward. And if you have an attachment style that's anything less than a secure attachment style, this will have a negative impact on your relationship. But this doesn't mean that you're not capable of being in a relationship. It just means that you need to work a lot harder than someone who has a secure attachment style to maintain a healthy relationship. Now, don't get me wrong, 40% of people have a secure attachment style. The rest of the 60 have the other styles. So what are attachment styles and how can we understand them? Number one, as already mentioned, secure attachment is the first attachment style. Only approximately 40 to 45% of the population in the world have a secure attachment style. Relationship therapist Silva Neves describes these people as being able to trust others easily and not second guessing them. People who have a secure attachment style are often comfortable in forming relationships with other people and don't have difficulty in trusting them. They're often confident in themselves and in others, and they're not easily scared by difficult situations. A secure attachment style is literally formed through the nurturing and caring that you're given as a child. Now, if you were brought up in a very, very comforting and nurturing home where both of your parents were responsive to your emotional and mental needs, you were able to form a strong bond with them, a strong and stable bond. This then formed the foundation and formed the building block of the kind of relationships that you would go ahead and have later on in the future. So the attachment style that you had with your parents highly contributed the kind of attachment that you're going to form in romantic relationships. This healthy relationship that you have with your parents often contributes to you having a healthier relationship with your romantic partners later. So if you have a secure attachment style, you do not struggle with trusting your partner. You are not scared about them leaving you. You're not scared about leaving them. You are confident in your relationship with them. You're confident in your security and in their security. And this is all reflective of the stable and secure relationship that you formed as a child. The second attachment style is anxious attachment. Insider magazine described people with an anxious attachment as often being scared that they're either too little for their partners or they're too much, and they often get anxious and worried about this. They take everything that happens in their relationship literally. Anxiously attached people find it really difficult to get into new relationships, and they find it really difficult to actually accept that they are liked for who they are. They don't understand how they can be in a relationship with someone and how someone can like them so easily. Relationship therapist Silver Neves describes people with an anxious attachment style as people who want other people to get close to them, but they get very scared that they might get hurt. So they crave that attachment, they crave that relationship, but they also have that fear of what if their heart gets broken. Some of the most common characteristics of having anxious attachment is having low self-esteem, having low self-worth, thinking that you're not enough, thinking that you're too much, being quite clingy with your partner, thinking that they might leave you, being scared that one day or another your partner will move on to someone else who will be better than you. The cause of anxious attachment is inconsistent parenting. This means that anxiously attached people had an upbringing where their parents were sometimes responsive to their emotional needs and sometimes they weren't. So those people didn't know what to expect. Those children didn't know whether to expect that love or whether to not expect that love, because they saw the side where they did receive it, but they also saw the side where they did the same things, but they didn't receive it. This then formed the building blocks for the kind of behavior that they might expect from their romantic partner, where maybe their romantic partner may be warm to them, but they also have the potential to leave them and avoid them. The last attachment style is avoidant attachment. People with an avoidant attachment style like to be in a relationship insofar as they are kept to themselves. Insider magazine describes people with an avoidant attachment style as people who either stay clear of relationships entirely or people who get into a relationship with a new partner but like to keep their partner at a distance. Often they purposely sabotage their own relationship so that their partner doesn't have the possibility to leave them and replicate the behavior that their parent displayed them. So avoidantly attached people were brought up in an environment where they weren't able to develop a secure and stable relationship with their parent. Growing up, their caregivers did not give in to their needs, they didn't provide them with the secure and stable environment they needed for their emotional and mental development. The love, care, and attention that's required to form a secure bond between a parent and a child was not present for people who have an avoidant attachment style. And that's why after these people grow up, they find it very difficult to trust someone new. They think that that person's going to leave them. So instead of trusting that person, they either keep them at a distance or they themselves carry out a behavior that will lead to that person leaving. Psychologist Alison Abram says that this behavior is actually quite ironic, because what avoidant attached people are doing is that they're engaging the kind of behavior to prevent from being left behind, but their behavior ends up actually resulting in them being left behind because their relationships are never secure, their relationships are never long lasting. The primary idea is that our attachment styles are formed on the basis of the relationships that we have as children, the relationships that we have with our parents. This then contributes to the attachment style that we form, which impacts our relationships, our romantic relationships moving forward. An attachment style has the potential to make or break your relationship. So if you have a secure attachment style, this is great for you because you can get into healthy relationships, you don't have difficulty in trusting other people, you're confident in your self-worth, you're confident in the relationship that you form with others. But the majority of attachment styles are either avoidant or anxious. This means that 60% of people did not have the secure and stable upbringing that they needed in order to form a coherent bond with their parent. And that's why either they have difficulty in trusting people or they have difficulty in getting relationships and thinking that they're enough. So if you're avoidantly attached, you're engaging in behaviors to purposely sabotage your relationship so that you can keep them at arm's distance and you don't get hurt, but you're still hurting the other person. Essentially what you're doing is you're stopping yourself from getting into a relationship, getting into a stable relationship that will give you a safe space. You're replicating the same sense of behaviors that your parent replicated when you were a little child, because they kept you at an arm's distance. They were not able to give you the safe and secure upbringing that you needed, and now you're doing the same thing by making yourself isolated and alone. If you have an anxious attachment and you were constantly given an inconsistent upbringing where your parents were sometimes warm to you and sometimes they weren't, getting into a relationship and constantly being clingy, asking your partner questions about whether they love you, whether they care about you, whether they're going to be with you forever, you're self-sabotaging your relationship because you're making them think that you don't think that you're enough, and you're contributing to your own dialogue, to your own story that maybe you aren't enough. It's a lot, I know. Anxious and avoidantly attached people have difficulties in maintaining healthy relationships, but it doesn't mean that it's something that you can't get out of. It doesn't mean that you can't unlearn your attachment style. Of course, you know, the relationships that we have with our parents have a huge impact on the relationships that we have moving forward, but it's not something that we can't unlearn. It's not something that we can't actively learn about and then tell ourselves that I don't want to behave like this anymore, I want to behave in a different way. So the idea isn't that you need to learn your attachment style so that you can feel bad about the way that you are in a relationship. The idea is that you can learn about your attachment style and then tell yourself, okay, these are the behaviors that I need to unlearn because I truly care about the relationship that I'm sharing with my partner and I want to work on it. And there's different ways in which you can do this. The first is that you can take the attachment quiz. The attachment quiz is in the captions below. Make sure that you take this attachment quiz so you're able to figure out whether you are securely, anxiously, or avoidantly attached to your partner. The second thing that you can do is speak to your partner about it, because if they are securely attached to you and you are either anxiously or avoidantly attached, they would have noticed these behaviors in you. Maybe they're afraid to tell you about it, or maybe they don't want to hurt your feelings. But being honest about your attachment style with your partner is going to contribute to you both working on it together to see what can be done about it. Another way to deal with this particular attachment style issue that you have is that once you figure out what attachment style you have, you can go back to the source of that difficulty, and that is your parents. Now, if they are alive, God willing, you can go back to your parents and see whether or not you can talk this out with them, because there are so many different forms of trauma and things that we take forward with us that contribute to our lives so much going forward. And sometimes the only thing you really need to do is take a couple of steps back, deal with that particular issue, and then move forward. And maybe that's what you need to do. Maybe you need to have that conversation with your parents. Maybe you need to talk to them about the difficulty that that particular relationship with them is having on your romantic relationships going forward, and together you can build a new relationship together. And if you aren't able to fix your relationship with them, if you think that, you know, it's too late now and I don't want to go back, then at least you can give yourself closure. At least you can come to the depths of why you feel this way in your romantic relationships, why you're self-sabotaging, why you think you're not enough. And hopefully, once you've given yourself that closure, you can close your old chapters and move on. Lastly, and this is something that I'd recommend if you truly, truly have difficulty in doing any of the others, is that you can try therapy. Therapy is a hugely, you know, important and amazing way of dealing with any past trauma that you have, sitting down with a professional, talking about the difficulties that you've had to see whether or not there's anything that can be done about them. I hope that this advice helps you. I hope that you're able to learn about your attachment style and then hopefully work on it. And I hope that this video helped you in figuring out what it is that's going wrong or right in your relationships. Often there are behaviors that we spend our entire lives learning about. So unlearning them is going to take time, but don't be so hard on yourself. Make sure that you are in it for the long run. You're not going to be able to unlearn lifelong behaviors overnight. Just give yourself time. Thank you so much for watching this video. I truly hope that you got something useful out of it. If you did, please like, comment, and subscribe. Please share, and I will see you all next week. Growing up, their caregivers did not meet their child giving...